So a few weeks ago, I saw some news about yet another SpongeBob movie that looks nothing like the original TV series, and it reminded me of just how much I enjoy the original SpongeBob SquarePants movie. It's just a classic. So I watched it again, but this time I decided to overanalyze a children's cartoon to find some interesting things that don't really make sense, but don't really need to make sense because it's a children's cartoon, but are interesting nonetheless, so here they are. 16 interesting things about the original SpongeBob movie. You know that scene where Plankton calls Mr. Krabs after he's just stolen the crown? He's calling as Clay. You don't know it at first, but then it shows him. It's Plankton on the phone, there's no one else around him. But the guy, Clay, sounds like a completely different person. Since when can Plankton do voices? Like, who's the voice of Clay?
Krabs, this is Clay, the guy you sold Neptune's crown to. Yeah, I just wanted to say thanks again for selling me the crown, Neptune's crown. I sold it to a guy in Shell City, and I just wanted to say thanks again for selling me the crown.
Also, you hear Plankton hang up the phone, you hear the click, but also he can still hear King Neptune screaming on the other end of the phone.
Which is not with Shell City, goodbye.
What's up with that? Why was the Krusty Krab formula completely unlocked and unguarded just because Mr. Krabs was frozen? Neither SpongeBob or Squidward did anything to help. They just left and it was unlocked or something? Even if Mr. Krabs wasn't frozen, wouldn't it still be locked or something? How come he could just, with his stubby legs, come on in here and just waltz on out with it? Also, why does Plankton have to say where the crown is in the first place at all? If he just sold it to Shell City and then didn't tell anyone, he wouldn't have to have hired Dennis to go in and exterminate SpongeBob and Patrick from getting it. No one would have suspected it was in Shell City. He could have just sold it to someone in Shell City and just kissed goodbye, not told anyone, and his plan probably would have worked. So you remember the creepy old ice cream lady from that monster? Well, at first she's coming from, like, the bottom of the monster's mouth, like, kind of where the tongue would be connected to. And then later on she's coming, like, from the back, like, from down the throat. Also, her hair and glasses that fell off reappear, just when she needs to talk again, I guess. Somehow, all of the creatures in Shell City, after they've come back to life, breathe air for ages, like they're not in any water. Mr. Krabs enters this bucket fully naked, yet emerges fully clothed.
Fire! Oh, yeah.
It has been confirmed that the events in the SpongeBob movie are canon. So how come SpongeBob can drive the paddy wagon, even though it's a running gag throughout the whole TV show that he can't drive? Of course, you don't need a license to drive a sandwich. But whether SpongeBob has a license or not doesn't change the fact that he's never seen with the ability to drive in the whole TV show. As it turns out, there might actually be an answer to this question. The SpongeBob movie, when it was initially created in 2004, it was planned to be the finale of the TV show. But then Nickelodeon renewed the TV series for a fourth season due to the film's success and just the popularity of the TV show. But since this movie was planned to be the finale, the events in it happen at the end of the SpongeBob timeline, making it the canonical ending of the SpongeBob timeline. This means any new TV show episodes or movies released after this point are set before this movie narratively. This explains why there's no Krusty Krab 2 in the series, why Plankton has never had the secret formula, and perhaps why SpongeBob can drive a stick. These two knee-slapping gas station owners are called Lloyd and Floyd. The very first character to appear in the SpongeBob movie is this guy, and his name is Squinty the Pirate. Potty the Parrot is voiced by the creator of SpongeBob, Stephen Hillenburg.
Shut up and look at the screen!
The bird's right!
Clay, the character that Plankton supposedly does when he's calling Mr. Krabs.
Hi, Mr. Krabs, this is Clay, the guy you sold Neptune's crown to.
Is voiced by Tom Kenny, the voice of SpongeBob. Clay is also the name of SpongeBob creator Steven Hillenburg's son in real life, Clay Hillenburg. No idea if that's an Easter egg or not, but there you go. Now you know that. Karen, Plankton's computer wife, is also the name of SpongeBob creator Steven Hillenburg's spouse. I guess he likes putting his family's name in the show, I don't know. In this scene, you can see a tough fish eating a bowl of nails without any milk. I assume that's a reference to that time, that, you know, the one. The original SpongeBob movie was the last animated Nickelodeon movie ever to be released on VHS. You may or may not have noticed that the design of King Neptune was changed for the movie. And this wasn't just an aesthetic choice. Basically, there was a legal firewall between Paramount and Nickelodeon. Basically, Paramount couldn't use some specific things from the TV show in the movie, for example, the design of King Neptune, but also Nickelodeon couldn't use things that first appeared in the movie in future episodes of the TV show, such as Mindy and the Goofy Goobers franchise. Apart from a few exceptions, this is why you don't see any references to the Goofy Goobers in the TV show until 2015, which is when the firewall ran out between Nickelodeon and Paramount. That's why in some newer episodes of the TV show, you will occasionally see Goofy Goobers, and in the 20th anniversary special, Mindy makes a cameo.